I'm Scott Laback, and in a moment, I'm going to talk about one of people's favorite subjects, cloud connectivity. So we're going to do a quick walkthrough of what a cloud exchange point is, how departments can onboard to a cloud exchange point, and we're going to also take a few minutes to remind everyone that the internet is still a powerful method to connect to the cloud. So in a few minutes, I'm going to do a quick walkthrough. Join me. Today I'm going to talk about readiness for onboarding to the cloud exchange point. Shared Services Canada is expected to have the Government of Canada's network connected to a cloud exchange point in April 2020. With departments' internet gateways often saturated, they're looking for dedicated bandwidth for their workloads in the cloud. So before we get into the readiness process, let's talk a little bit about what is a cloud exchange point. If you're currently an infrastructure as a service user, you know about services such as AWS Direct Connect or Azure Express Route that allow you to take traffic off internet connections and onto dedicated connections with dedicated bandwidth. Before you can establish those type of connections, the Government of Canada must physically connect its network to each of the cloud providers. That connection happens at co-location centers in major internet hubs such as Montreal, Toronto, and Vancouver. To save the Government of Canada from making individual connections to each of the providers, we turn to a cloud exchange provider who aggregates all the cloud providers' networks to one point. The GC then only has to connect to that one cloud exchange provider. This then allows departments to deploy services such as Direct Connect and Express Route. It's important to note that the CXP is for connecting infrastructure and platform as a service environments. For software as a service, such as Office 365, G Suite, and Salesforce, a different type of connectivity known as an internet exchange point will be used. The IXP is not in scope for today's discussion. It's also worth noting that the internet, type one here, is a very important type of connectivity that allows us to securely connect to public clouds today. We're going to talk a little bit more about the internet towards the end of the presentation. So the CXP is important for hybrid architectures, where we want to connect cloud applications to applications that are on-prem. Here in Usage Profile 5, we're talking about applications that are accessed by GC employees. For Profile 6, we're talking about applications in the cloud that are accessed by non-GC employees, and those applications in turn connect back to applications on-prem. Here we see those usage profiles and connection types shown visually. Profile 5 and 6 are at the bottom of the screen. So now that we understand what the CXP is, let's talk about the readiness process for onboarding. So quite a few departments have raised their hands saying they have hybrid architectures, requiring applications on-prem to be connected to those in the cloud. Shared Services Canada's capacity to onboard departments to the CXP is limited to 2 departments per month. Demand for onboarding exceeds the capacity that's available. To make sure that the departments being onboarded are fully ready to use the CXP, a connectivity readiness process was endorsed by the Government of Canada Enterprise Architecture Review Board. Departments must demonstrate readiness before they are prioritized for onboarding. So let's look at what that process looks like. First, you have to obtain a cloud account. You probably already have this today. You also have to obtain an IP address allocation from Shared Services Canada. You must then apply the Government of Canada cloud guardrails to your environment, and SSC must verify that those guardrails are properly applied. So far, this process is in place today and is known as the operationalization framework. The readiness process builds upon that by requiring that your cloud environment be security assessed and an authority to operate is granted. So the security assessment must be appropriate for the workloads you're deploying. If you're deploying unclassified workloads, the security assessment must be appropriate for that. For protected workloads, likewise. The appropriate designated officer within your department must be made aware and accept the security risks. The next step is to then sign an agreement with Shared Services Canada. You also have to be able to articulate your network flows, which applications on-prem are talking to those in the cloud. At this point, you can demonstrate readiness and be prioritized for onboarding. Once you've onboarded, you can deploy your hybrid solutions and operate them. This, of course, is a high-level view. Shared Services Canada has produced a readiness guide, which describes each of the activities in greater detail. That readiness guide can be found on the cloud wiki. Simply wiki.gccollab.ca/cloud will take you to the page. You scroll down to the technical build, and here you'll find the readiness process. Likewise, going to the French site, you will find the French document. Once you open the document, you'll find each of the activities described in detail. Links have been provided to additional information or tools that help you complete the activity. As well, a frequently asked question is provided in the guide. So up to now, we've reviewed what a CXP is and the readiness process to onboard to the CXP. I'd like to take a moment though and talk about the internet. Some departments may feel frustrated as they're not yet ready to prove readiness or are not a priority for onboarding. And they feel for that reason their cloud adoption activities must come to a halt. It's important to note that our enterprise internet services are still very powerful in that they can provide many of the connectivity scenarios that we seek. Note how both the EIS and the CXP start at the government backbone and end at a cloud service provider. Of course, we use the internet today to connect to our cloud management consoles in accordance to the cloud console access guardrail. But what if we want to connect an application that's in the cloud back to one that's on-prem? This again is where the internet can serve as a means of communication. By applying API gateways and using RESTful APIs, you can securely have two applications communicate with each other. So let's do a little bit of myth busting that exists around cloud connectivity. The first myth we often see is, I need a SCED to connect to the cloud. This, of course, is incorrect. You're connected to the cloud today through the internet. The second thing is, SCED is an initiative, not a thing. It stands for Secure Cloud Enablement and Defense, and it'll deliver secure dedicated connections to the cloud. This includes the cloud exchange point. The second myth that we see is SCED makes my environment protected B. This, of course, is also incorrect. It's only after a security assessment of your cloud environment and your operations against the protected B security control profile and an authority to operate is granted that your department is ready to host protected B applications. Third myth, and related to the second one, is I can't achieve a protected B authority to operate without using the CXP. This, of course, again, is incorrect. It is your assessment of the environment and its controls and the authority to operate that's applied that determines if it's ready to host protected B applications. Again, internet connections can be used and with the proper security controls be used to host protected B applications. So what are the next steps for departments? The first is you should determine if and when you need the cloud exchange point. If you do need it, demonstrate readiness. Once you've demonstrated readiness, you'll be prioritized for onboarding. So let's recap a few of the things that we've learned today. The cloud exchange point provides dedicated connectivity from the Government of Canada's network to cloud service providers' networks. A readiness process for onboarding to the CXP must be completed by departments before they are prioritized for onboarding. And finally, don't forget about the internet and the power of APIs to allow on-prem to cloud connectivity between applications. Thank you very much.